And we're back in the attic. We got a full house tonight.
Yeah, we do. We got a party up in here.
That's Charlie. I don't know if you guys know that voice.
He's on the episode again. Yep. This is Danny.
Welcome back, Cotter.
So we got Adam here and Phil.
Say something, Adam.
Hello.
Thank you,
Hi.
Phil. That was Adam. Just so you know the voice, we need to let the listeners know the voices.
I don't think they care.
Even though Phil will know when he listens to it.
I'm going
to
say, yeah, like, the listener, you mean me?
And Adam will never know.
Phil, do you know your own voice?
It's going to be hard for me to keep you and I straight. Yeah. I don't know which one of us.
It's pretty difficult. We sound the same.
Actually, we got some comment again on this week.
Was it Fag Sick Butthole?
No, someone else.
Oh, really? What'd they say?
They said Paul Blart is cinematic gold.
Cool.
Like it.
If you're out there, I hate you.
I think it was a joke.
We know who you are, sure, and we hate you.
It was Danny.
That was on a lot last week.
It could be Larry. Larry legitimately likes that movie.
Yeah, it's probably because he's fat.
Not only is that a bad movie, it's not even the best mall cop movie of that year.
Fuck you, Ronnie. Fuck you, Ronnie.
What was the best mall cop
movie? Observe and Report.
Oh. It was actually funny, but then Steve kept repeating that thing so much.
I hated Fuck You, Ronnie.
Dude, they're doing like heroin in the bathroom. Anytime they do heroin in a comedy, it's just great. Like in Wet Hot American Summer.
Yeah. When they go into town and it only was an hour long.
Yeah, right. And they're doing like hard drugs.
I gotta throw this out there. The Dedham Community Theater is showing that.
Really?
Yes.
It's showing Wet Hot American Summer?
Yes.
When? Right now?
No, yes. No. It's like they're doing like their own midnight movie thing, like
Rhode Island.
And it's on like a Friday a couple weeks. Like
we gotta go.
So. Yeah.
I'll do that.
Yeah.
Oh, they're doing their own midnight movie thing?
Yeah.
We didn't do anything this year. Why didn't we look that up?
We did look it up.
We did look it up. Danny and I were going to go to Blade Runner one night, but then we got
drunk. Nobody wanted to go.
Whoops. What else was there? Anything?
Nobody wanted to go.
No, there's really
Poltergeist. There was Poltergeist, dude.
Poltergeist, yeah. I've seen that a lot.
There's nothing else, though?
I'd say there's a...
You didn't want to see Akira last year.
Yeah. There was a what? Beyond Thunderdome?
No, I don't think that was there.
I thought one of the Mad Maxes was. I don't know which one.
God.
Oh, Fury Road was the second one. Fury Road's the new one they're doing.
The first year.
One of them was
Oh, yeah, they're making one, though.
Road Warrior 2.
Road Warrior, Mad Max.
Yeah, it was Road Warrior 2.
Yeah, then Beyond Thunderdome, whatever. That
yeah.
The one with Tina Turner.
The first year that we found that out, that year was great. There was just every movie ever
was there.
The first year we found out about it. And then after that, it's been... Because
I think
like
they
had Monty Python, man.
Monty Python was good. They have like one to two select movies that we have to see now.
I was drunk for Monty Python.
Cabin in the Woods should be.
I was kind of drunk for The Matrix.
I was very drunk.
Yeah.
We were drinking the, what was it, whiskey? Like out of a water bottle on the way there.
And then we stopped at Chili's, didn't we?
Yeah. And then Sandy passed out at the Holy Grail.
Yeah, yeah.
Remember he passed out in the chair with his legs off, so no one could get in and out of the aisle?
Oh, he totally did. I loved the Holy Grail. That was so good.
Yeah, that was funny.
Okay. So, Danny, where are we? Where are we today? What's in the news?
Well, instead of talking about old movies that everyone's seen 1,000 times, we're going to talk about the new movie, ParaNorman.
Wait, I saw Safe House this week.
That's an old movie, too, but...
I know.
I saw Judge Dredd, too.
You did?
Yeah.
Did you? Oh, you never saw that, though.
Yeah, I saw parts of it before, but I've never seen the whole thing. I like parts of it.
I saw Crazy Stupid Love. We all saw some movies. How about that?
I saw The Sitter.
Oh.
with Jonah Hill?
Yeah.
Fat Jonah.
Yeah.
Hey, how come you had to drop out of going to Maine?
Oh, because of the girlfriend's mother.
Oh, okay.
She's
because he put a thing on Facebook. He's like, my brother and his girlfriend couldn't go, so $50 for the room.
I didn't put a thing on Facebook.
I said your brother did.
Oh. I don't use Facebook.
He said my brother and his girlfriend couldn't go.
Huh?
Facebook is stupid.
Its
stock is dropping.
I agree.
Invest now.
Okay. It's gonna go up. So here we go. And then, Danny, after we talk about ParaNorman.
Yeah, we're going to get into the video games. Everybody played Darksiders except for Phil because Phil doesn't know how to play video games.
Yeah, I don't know.
Wait, I watched Paranormal Activity 3.
Oh, what the hell is wrong with you?
Why don't you just commit suicide?
It was okay.
No, it wasn't.
I've never seen
awful.
Any of them.
I saw the commercial for the fourth one the last time I was at the
theater. There was a fourth one?
Yes.
Yeah.
Oh,
I'm probably going to end up seeing it. The girlfriend, like, I'm watching it. I'm kind of, like, laughing at it. She's like, this shit's real. I was like, no, it's not. did you see the, like, there's a part in it, like, when you go into, like, the bathroom, you say, like, Bloody Mary 3 times, and, like, you turn off the light, and when you turn it back on, supposedly it's, like, a ghost or whatever in there.
Yeah, it's Bloody Mary.
And she's like, that shit's real. I said, I'll go fucking do this right now.
Did you do it?
No, I didn't want to get up.
There's a good episode of Supernatural about.
Oh, that. Jesus.
What happens if you actually do that and like a Bloody Mary appears in your hand? Like, sweet.
I know.
I like the Biggie Smalls thing from South Park. Biggie Smalls. Oh man, what's going on? He's just chasing Randy down the hall with his gun.
That's awesome.
Yeah. She's gonna get so mad at me if she hears it.
Does she listen to the podcast?
No.
Because you're dissing Paranormal.
She will listen to this one episode.
It's not that I'm dissing Paranormal, it's just I'm dissing that whole like believing in ghosts thing.
Oh.
Yeah.
I believe in ghosts, but paranormal activity is so fake.
You don't? I don't like. She watches like the thing on there's a
Ghost
show,
Hunters
or something like that on Sci-Fi or whatever.
There are so many of those now. It's like six off. Of them.
It's like the same show. Like the guy's like in the stairway and he's like talking to the ghost and this thing machine takes the energy and creates it back into like voice, and it's like kill 60. I'm like, that's fucking fake. I said they're just doing that so it's good. I was like, kill 60, but it's fucking
kill 61.
I saw one. Like I turned on the TV and it was how on. They were in like a haunted house, and they're like, oh, who do you want gone? And they just this is all they heard. Like, did you? She said Sarah. I'm like, no. All I heard was a. Like the wind went by the mic or something. Like Sarah. I'm like, no, that was.
The boom mic hit the wall.
Oh, it said boom. Oh, it's gonna blow us up.
I just don't understand like how like so many people like, you know, how does this device create energy into fucking voice? That is the most retarded thing ever.
Like, it makes sense seeing like heat signatures in
the
air.
Yeah,
that
maybe
makes sense.
Maybe that, but like I don't know.
But even then, like, oh, it's more hotter over here. That doesn't mean there's spectral energy.
Oh, it's more hotter over here. There's like a furnace right there. Like, so hot over there. That's a furnace, dumbass.
Just so you know, you both just suck at grammar.
Why?
It's more hotter over here.
Whatever.
What I say.
Thanks, Adam.
I don't remember what
that's why we
it
brought
was
you
annoying.
In, that's why we brought you in the show to correct our grammar.
That's like something Nick would say to me.
Right.
It was annoying.
I just the one thing I like about Nick is because clearly, you know, this side of the table is not that smart. And he doesn't the only one he corrects is Danny.
Yeah.
It's true.
That is the only one he says anything about. Sometimes he might, well, you know, that could be wrong, but he's Danny, what are you, fucking an idiot? What's the matter with you?
And the problem is,
he's
like,
wicked Italian too.
That is awesome.
We don't read comic Italian books or anything, or like really do any of the same things Danny does, except for like play video games. But like, we don't have any way of checking Danny's facts when it comes to comics. He goes home and Nick is like, no, he wasn't even in that one. He hasn't been in it since like 2002.
The
Danny's
Flash
like, oh, yeah,
can't
right.
even do that. He was dead at the time.
He like says to me and Kim, we're like, yeah, okay.
Yeah.
And Nick is like, Danny, you're an idiot.
Yeah.
Where'd you come up with this fact?
Well, he remembers everything in Green Lantern. Like, we pretty much read like 50 issues, which is like that's like 5 years worth in like 6 months when we started reading it, and like I forgot it all, but he remembers it all.
Really?
Yeah.
All right.
Cool story, bro. I know.
Yeah, yeah. Cool story, bro. Thanks for telling us how much of a life you and Nikki have.
Hey.
I see him at Stop and Shop every once in a while.
Do you wave hi?
Yes.
The best thing
he's
is...
Always, he's
like,
funny.
Really? Like, because every time I see him, he just, like, stops dead and, like, whatever he's doing, he's like... And he just stares at me. He's like, as I walk by, I'm like, whoa. All right. Hey, Nick, bye.
Is he, like, deer in headlights, though? Is he like, oh, God.
No,
no
he
he's,
just,
like grimacing.
Yeah, just, legitimately just stops whatever he's doing and just slowly stares as, like, as I, like, walk by.
It's not creepy.
Not that I see him often.
I walked in and I was waving to him and he was like over in like the fruits and he's walking by just kind of staring at me and he stops and he goes, me? Me? Oh, get out of here.
He's so bashful. He does the bashful. Hey, yo.
It's more
okay,
gay
so
than bashful what you just
shut
did.
Up.
Yeah, Dan, that wasn't
that,
bashful.
That's me
was,
doing
was
it,
gay.
Though. It's bashful
Danny,
when he
if
does it.
If Danny was one of the seven dwarfs,
it.
He'd be gay.
He'd be gay?
He wouldn't be bashful. He'd be gay.
You mean happy?
Technically, in the original, none of them are actually, you know, named at all.
But
really?
They do rape Snow White.
No.
Oh, that's just fables.
<I'm sorry. laughs> Where the fuck did that come from?
I must have missed that scene in the Disney version.
No.
Not even in the original is not that long. It's just the queen's a bitch, and then Snow White comes, meets the little dwarves, and then the prince is like, oh, let's go get her. And somehow they come back. Something happens to the queen. I don't remember. It was just stupid.
Is this in the book?
This is yeah in Grimm's okay. Fairy Tales.
Yeah, I've only read,
but none of them are named. So. That's just what Disney did.
No, but I was thinking in the comic book fables, like the first collection
I'm
you
sure
read,
they take some liberties there.
Yeah, but Boy Blue's like never mentioned the dwarfs, and then later you find out she was like raped for like
really
10 years by the dwarves.
This is in fables.
Yeah, the comic fables.
I don't remember that part.
Yeah, you haven't got that far yet.
Oh, okay.
That's actually a side story, too.
By the way, did you say Boy Blue?
Yeah, Boy Blue.
He's not in it, is he?
What?
Are you ruining things for me?
He's in the first part.
Okay.
No, the first six issues.
I was
going
to say, if he comes
collection.
Back from the dead or something, man, you're ruining life for
no,
me.
No spoils, man, but thank Boy you. Blue is awesome. I'm just saying.
Boy Blue is awesome.
It's really Snow
so
White's
is the
two
Frog
separate
Prince.
Stories.
Yeah, Flycatcher.
Snow White's awesome. Two separate stories.
Yeah. The one that
kind of like
knows.
Alice in Wonderland?
No, it's an entirely different one. Snow White and Red Rose or something. Than other sisters or some shit like that. They meet
yeah,
some
Red
bear
Rose.
Some Briar bear Rose. That turns into a prince at the end. I don't know.
I know all about Red shit. Rose. She's in Fables.
You talking about Briar Rose?
No, that's called Red Rose.
That's Sleeping Beauty, Briar Rose.
Cool.
Dude.
Cool.
Dude.
Yeah, there's Rose Red. It's the other one.
So, all right. So, all right. Did you guys all see ParaNorman together?
Four out of the five here saw ParaNorman.
No, everyone saw ParaNorman.
You saw ParaNorman?
Yeah.
Oh, five out of the five saw ParaNorman. This is a simile.
This is, wow.
This all is right, you what? Need to stop talking.
Yeah, so did you guys all go together?
Yeah.
Oh. Did yeah, you guys so. Have like a shit ton of kids?
Oh. No. We had a crying all baby right, throughout
the
entire
wait,
movie.
Let's start with the crowd. Danny, you can do the crowd all for right, us.
All right, all right. Let me
so
get
what time
crowd.
Was your showing?
2:30
oh, that's
on a
early.
Sunday
that's
today.
Early.
We're watching it. And then the movie's about to start, and just a group of 20 Asians just come tracing in a line.
20
yeah.
No, legitimately,
a
whole
20
yeah.
Asians.
Yeah.
It
the
was
whole
rough.
Row yeah. just filled up with Asians. This is the craziest thing I've ever seen.
But they were quiet, I think. But somebody had a baby that kept
it was them.
Crying. Was it them?
Yes.
Those I don't Asians. Know. Someone else had two.
Was it like three generations
girls,
of Asian family?
The fuck out when the thing's
yeah,
head
it was
popped
actually.
Off.
Like, there was like the old family. It was ridiculous.
Yeah, but the baby was crying for like half. It was awful.
It's kind of interesting that ParaNorman brings out the Asian crowd.
It's probably because the Asians love Nightmare Before Christmas, so they probably love ParaNorman too.
They
how
do,
how
really?
Do you know that?
Nightmare yeah. Before Christmas is big in Asia.
He likes really to go around pulling Asians.
What are your favorite movies?
No, the Japanese like it. I'm sorry.
Do you like Tokyo Story?
No, I've never seen it. I'm sorry.
Do you like Old Boy?
That's Korean.
Oh,
okay.
Asian.
It is Asian.
It's a difference. Yeah.
So you had one crying baby.
Yeah, and then we had kids making noise. Like there's one scene Adam was talking about when the like a zombie's head comes off and like someone jumped and screamed.
Yeah, they were screaming for yeah. no reason.
That was oh, really?
I didn't know that the head was gonna fall off when he picked him up by the head. Who would have thought that?
Oh, you just spitting image of a girl there.
There's no video going on.
You'd be
on
surprised.
With this.
Usually, turns
sexy.
Out it's an old Jewish lady.
It's always an old Jewish lady.
Always. His accent
I
is
don't
always
understand.
An old Jewish lady.
Why would they do that? The zombies. Why would they should talk it out? Why they have to eat them? I don't know.
He sounds like the grandmother.
Yeah. The grandmother but movie. I mean, yeah. I'd give our audience a 4 out of 7.
Wow, that's pretty low, though.
Why out of 7?
That's we had to pick a
our
scale.
Attic podcast 7-star scale.
It's retarded. It's I agree.
Well, I don't. He has such a. I don't like. What's the difference? He has such a
five
hard time
star,
between
man.
5 and 10. Like he's
seven's
okay with
so arbitrary.
He's
though.
Even okay with 10, but
dude,
the
that's
7
the point.
Just
we're trying to make ourselves different. We're trying to be our own people.
By
yeah,
being retarded,
Charlie, you're special all on your own.
That's true.
I don't understand why being 7 makes it retarded.
Yeah,
because
why does it make
no,
it retarded?
That's like measuring using inches. It's just dumb.
Yeah, you know that our country, you know, does that, right?
I know it's dumb.
They did it for years, Danny. Things
metrics.
Got built okay.
No, when they build stuff, they use well. No, not always. It doesn't matter.
Yeah, a lot of people don't know metrics exist.
Machaca.
Really?
Metrics is good.
I thought that's that workout machine.
Metrics.
Or no, is that the steroid?
Or the band metric?
No.
Or the Matrix. Anyway.
Anyways.
So yeah, I gave it a 4 because the crying baby. If it wasn't for the crying baby, I gave
well,
it a 6.
Well, I had 2 cell phones.
Oh,
dude, I had some cell phones go off.
I had 2 cell phones. I had Charlie like 6. I like this movie.
Dude, I was like 4
what
seats
do you mean,
away from
I
Danny.
Like
there's the kids. The kids said, "I like this movie."
Like during the movie.
Yeah.
What part did he say that?
Just randomly.
When did you go?
I was like a 4:15. Did you guys see it in 3D?
No,
no.
We went 2D.
They had fucking. They had 2D showings yeah. and like a bazillion 3D ones.
Yeah.
And the two times for the normal ones are like wicked early in the morning.
Yeah.
Yeah. It was like
so
new.
You saw it in 3D.
Yeah.
How was the 3D?
Not great.
Yeah, I didn't expect it to be.
No, I watched that movie. I didn't see one part that would even be
maybe like, that. Maybe that owl thing that was, you know, flying around, that could have done it.
When he's getting premonitions.
Was it originally filmed in 3D or no?
Yeah, it was. Because really? I mean, they just. I mean, it's weird with those because they film frame by frame.
Yeah, so, it's animation. Like, it's different than like a, you know, live action being filmed.
Well, it's also different if you have like 3D animation. It's much easier to retrofit 3D onto that. But I mean, if you're using 2D,
yeah, it's stop motion.
Well, actually, like old Disney cartoons, they used to do the foreground and the background and do them differently. So they'd end up just putting the shot of the foreground on the same background.
Yeah, but so,
that's a lot easier to do 3D on that because you just have the different frames and layers.
You know
them
too much about
other.
That. How do you know so much?
They don't do it anymore because do you know what the last frame by frame animated?
No, but
Disney
you're gonna tell
was?
Us what?
Home on the Range, starring Roseanne and
really
and what's his face? Cuba Gooding Jr.
That just sounds
Oscar
terrible.
Winning Cuba Gooding Jr.
Yeah,
Cuba.
Yeah. Home on the Range sucks.
Cuba.
I'm just saying, but that was the last single celled animated Disney movie.
Okay, so
that's nice.
Yay.
So.
Yay, factoids.
So you saw it at Foxborough?
No.
Really?
Yeah.
North Attleboro?
No.
Oh, you're going to the other one now?
Yeah, the Randolph?
Randolph. Is that your new place?
It's if I'm over her house, yeah. It's only like a couple minutes down the road.
That's a big screen though, right?
Yeah.
Randolph is a nice theater. I saw There Will Be Blood there.
I'm not going to lie. Like, I was telling, like, I asked, I like, for some reason, like, I know Foxborough and them are both stadium seating. I'm more comfortable there.
Just because it's bigger?
At Randolph?
Yeah. No, not because it's bigger.
The seats?
Yeah, the seats at fucking Foxborough I do not like.
I'm going to have to go to Randolph just to like test it out.
You've never been there?
No.
Because that was used to be like before they built Foxborough, like, oh, let's go to the stadium seating place, and that's the only place you can go.
No, Hoyts, man. But now Hoyts is now Regal.
Regal.
Yeah. Isn't that right off of a highway?
Yeah, it's right off of 95. No, 93?
No idea.
I think sounds right.
Yeah. I just go on roads. I don't know.
I don't know roads either. I think it's 93, though. It's big. It's huge. It's two floors.
No, I'm trying to think if that's the place that I'm thinking of.
Yeah. It's two floors and everything.
Probably. It's like the original stadium seating besides Bellingham.
I don't think I've ever been there, but I've been around there. Passed it.
It's pretty bad. Like, if you go, like, at night for, like, a hardcore movie, you have to park across the street.
What's a hardcore movie?
Like, anything popular.
Boys in the Hood?
Yeah.
Twilight?
Twilight. Twilight, you're going to have to park across the street.
Yeah, or, like, The Dark Knight Rises, you're going to have to park across the street because it'd be packed. That's what it means.
Oh, it's kind of a pain in the ass.
You know what I saw there? Harry Potter.
Which one?
Sorcerer's Stone.
Oh, well, that one's okay.
Is that what it's called?
Yeah.
First one?
Yeah. Philosopher's Stone. We're not British.
In the Stone?
That movie's good. I actually like Sword in the Stone.
Black Cauldron?
I don't like that one.
But I like parts of Black Cauldron, man.
What time do matinees start, though?
Is anything before 4, I think?
5.
Oh, shit. I thought
6.
5.
Is it 6?
Is it 6?
Because it costs
for North Attleboro, it's 6.
Yeah. Is it different per one?
Yeah.
It changes for theater.
Because it was $27 for the two of us.
Well, it was 3D too. So
yeah, but I was hoping it would still be cheaper because I thought it would be matinee.
3D is cheaper in matinee. Oh, no, it's just on this Tuesday.
Yeah, but maybe it wasn't matinee.
That's a deal.
Yeah, what time did you go?
3D is
4:15, I said that.
I agree. Ooh, 3D is dumb.
How was that not matinee?
I don't know.
Maybe it's a Randolph thing.
Yeah. It sucked. No, I didn't. 3D.
It was
wasn't
a Friday though, wasn't it?
No, we went Saturday.
Oh, Saturday.
Yeah. That might be why.
No, Saturday. I think they'd have the actual matinee. I don't know. Who knows? All right, but Kimball, what do you think of the movie though?
I liked it.
Yeah, Charlie.
I liked it. I enjoyed it. I did. I thoroughly, thoroughly enjoyed it.
I think everyone liked it, right?
Yeah, I think we all can agree.
Anybody have any problems with it? Anybody have any problems with it anywhere?
The crowd sucked.
With the movie, you jerk.
Oh, I'm sorry. No, I actually loved it. I love
me too.
Stop motion animation stuff.
Yeah, that's good stuff. I was telling Danny last night actually about Shaun the Sheep. It's a good TV show. Watch it.
By Aardman, you were telling me.
Yes, by the people who do
Wallace and Gromit, Chicken Run, and
I love the
Chicken
Run.
Pirates. I forced my family Pirates? To go see that when we were on vacation when it came out.
Chicken Run?
Yeah.
That one's good.
It is good. I like Chicken Run.
Chicken Run is really good. Yeah. Before Mel Gibson got all crazy.
I think
is that Mel Gibson in there?
Yeah, Mel Gibson's in it. He's a weed.
Oh.
Fantastic Mr. Fox is the best.
Oh, yeah.
That's good.
I'm telling you,
you should
have
watched Pirates, though. Pirates. That's pretty good.
What is Pirates?
I do want to see Pirates.
Hugh Grant, and he's like a captain.
Oh, the thing
ship.
That came out a few months ago?
Yeah.
You guys suck.
I hate Hugh Grant.
Mm.
But they have a, it's a good cast besides him on that. You can listen to that podcast where I talk about that movie.
But so yeah, we all liked it. All enjoyed it.
Yeah.
It's good. It had some, you know, had some laughs in there, some seriousness.
Who was your
there.
Favorite character?
Casey Affleck had some pretty good lines.
Yeah, he was
the,
funny.
The jock dude.
Oh yeah, he was good.
I liked him. He was funny.
His best line is when he's like, "All you guys do is burn and murder," and he's just that's
and
all.
And the
he
dude
says.
Just pulls down the torch.
Yeah, one torch. But that movie is so much adult humor.
Yeah.
Like,
the Did
first
you think,
time
you think
I realized
a lot,
it was
though? Like, yeah. like there was it was oh, in there, but I wouldn't say that there is a lot.
No, I think there was.
Well, I realized the dad really drove it home for me how adult it was. Like the dad didn't like him. He's a freaking weirdo. I don't like him. But the part
how
where
is that
I,
adult humor?
Right in the beginning when he watched Sex and Violence.
No, that's he's parenting. A freaking weirdo.
Oh, yeah. I don't see that as adult humor.
Well,
because
kids are really accepting it. Well, they don't usually
not
judge
humor,
each other.
But it's adult content in that the father doesn't accept him. But you bring up a good point where he's like, oh, I'm just watching Sex and Violence on the TV. Like, that was adult. And then the part where he's like, that statue just pissed at us. And it made it sound like they were saying piss. Get it?
I like that he's like, yeah.
Good. That was good.
John Goodman was awesome.
Yeah.
Yeah. Especially when he's like trying to explain it to him and he can't like breathe. He's like almost dying.
He probably was really dying.
Yeah. I like the part.
They probably made him run like the treadmill. All right, go read these lines quick.
I like the part where like he like dies, but he comes back in. Ha! Not this time. But he just dies.
Yeah, that was good. I liked that too.
Yeah. Yeah. Like,
Dick. Sorry.
What? And Casey Affleck was good, and then like all the voice acting
all
was
the
really
voice,
good. Yeah.
All the voice acting was good.
What'd you think of his
sister?
Yeah,
I liked Chris
Anna Kendrick's character. Yeah.
She had a Nicki Minaj ass.
That
what
thing
was
fucking,
yeah, it
was it
was what?
Ridiculous.
Why did they do that?
That was odd, actually.
Yeah. Not as big as the cop who's like hitting the butt.
Yeah,
the
she was
yeah, but that
fat,
that was different. That was different.
Oh, I love the line where it's like, it's probably the sky is probably messed up because of global warming from those cell phones. She takes a sip of the drink and then throws it in the woods.
Yeah,
killing
yeah,
the ozone.
I like that.
Where are all the cops? Bam!
Oh, that one was awesome. Yeah.
That was the loudest I heard you laugh, Adam, when that part happened.
It was hilarious.
I just heard all of a sudden, I just hear Adam, oh!
Where's
like,
the cops when you need them? And then she just barrels through the car.
I told Danny, I really like the, you know, stop shooting civilians. That's the for the police to do. I was like,
that was good.
Civilians. I was like, ah, it's good.
Yeah. And I like that the zombies turned out to be like sort of misunderstood. They're like, we just want you to end the curse, but everyone's just trying to kill them. Yeah. Like one of the zombies has like a plunger on its head and it's just kind of running away. And then like they almost murdered all the kids when they're trapped in the town hall. They just like throwing fire.
Yeah,
and
yeah,
stuff.
Yeah. That was funny. Yeah. I'm not going to lie.
You know what else was kind of adult in my eyes? Was that boyfriend thing. That was a little surprising to me.
That was awesome.
Yeah.
What?
My boyfriend
at the
liked
end,
Netflix.
Yeah, my boyfriend
oh,
liked Chick Flix.
Yeah.
What? That was a little adult because kids really won't understand that. You know
really,
what I mean?
I didn't. I thought he was just confused. He didn't know who he was, but yeah, he's gay. All right. That makes sense. It makes sense to me now.
I'm sure confused. It does. Your life in a movie, right?
Yes, I'm very buff in real life.
You realize
you
this
well.
Later on.
I like that. I'm sorry, baby. It's okay. She like goes.
Yeah,
like
he goes.
And he's like talking to the car.
I was gonna say the van was my favorite character.
Yeah. Yeah, when it's just like bouncing down
yeah,
the hill.
Yeah, yeah.
I like Christopher Mintz Plasse. He was awesome. He was a bully.
Yeah, but
oh, he was good too.
I like that he was breakdancing. That was kind of random.
That was so funny. He didn't really break it down too well though. Like they could have went.
He's like
nuts.
Trying to do the worm, and he like only lifted up his butt.
I like how he just
oh, is that what that was?
Everything.
I couldn't I think that's what he was trying to do.
Yeah.
I just straight up thought he was wanted to hump the ground. I thought that's what I thought he wanted to do. I was like, whoa, that's kind of, whoa. That's pushing it. This
yeah, really is adult.
Yeah, that's what I thought. I thought he really wanted to hump the ground.
Yeah, I thought he was humping the ground too. I was like, that's weird.
It makes
creepy.
More sense now that he was trying to do the worm.
Oh my God.
Wow, you guys are really good at this.
What are you doing? Why are you trying to fuck concrete?
I didn't understand. Well, there's cardboard in there.
Well, that's just the condom.
Oh. Had to look cushion. That makes a lot more sense now.
But like the animation style is really good, like for stop motion.
Yeah,
like,
it was. I liked it. Yeah, I really liked the animation. I liked the. I think some of the best animation was with the sky. When it was the witch, and just like even the way I thought it was some of the best animation in there.
So yeah, I just had
like almost went into like two heads a couple times. Yeah, in the sky.
I just had the same because like it was 3D, so it was a little dark.
Oh yeah, that's the problem with that.
Yeah.
That had to suck. I don't understand. That was like, so good.
You think they couldn't like? Can they turn like make the projector a little bit brighter?
Yeah, because for Transformers 3, like Michael Bay was really pushing like, all right, we need to go in there and tell them to put these projectors brighter for the movie.
Because you can do that then?
Yeah. But it's like it's theater by theater, so like it's hard to get all the theaters in line.
Yeah, yeah.
Didn't like, you see when Malick released Tree of Life? He gave them like specifications. I can't even
speak. Wow, you didn't murder that.
Specifications.
Yeah, I can't even speak on like how he wanted it shown, how he wanted the lights in the theater, how he wanted the projection. Yeah. So they do that.
Because they should definitely make them a little brighter.
Yeah. I just try not to see them. But like you said, try not like to. Opening weekend, like it's like all 3D.
I couldn't believe it because like they didn't even rip my stubs because like I don't want to give the 3D my money just because I don't want to like just like say, hey, people are liking this.
Yeah.
And so they didn't rip our stubs. I was like, maybe we should leave. Just so we can get our money back. Yeah. And then I'll go buy tickets for the regular one.
Yeah.
That happened to me and Danny during Hellboy, even though we didn't know we were there with each other.
Oh, yeah.
Well, that they gave us new ones. Yeah.
Right? Because I went with you and I think Phil, right?
Yeah.
Yes.
They gave you new
ones. But then Danny did happen
new
to be
tickets because the print
Nikki.
Caught on fire.
With Nikki,
end.
Of course.
Did we have the print, what do you mean?
Yeah, we have
like the film of it caught on fire.
Actually,
and, like,
caught on
off screen.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
How was that?
It was right when it was like they were fighting at the end in the little clock area thing.
So what happened? Did you guys have to leave? Or
no, we just stayed there for 15 minutes.
Yeah.
They fixed it.
Yeah,
it
wasn't like a
tickets.
Huge fire. It was just the film melted.
Yeah.
So what, did they skip a few frames and rerun it?
Yeah, pretty much. I don't know. It's hard to tell because it was like 20 minutes. We're waiting for the thing to start up.
I think
again.
It missed a little bit, but not much.
I bought it on DVD later, so I saw it.
Would you get
on
Blu-ray?
No, I didn't.
What happened? I have it on Blu-ray.
Jesus,
I know.
Danny.
I got to upgrade. I'm sorry.
What's wrong with you, Danny?
What didn't you? Oh, my God. Danny didn't get on. Did you hear, guys? Danny bought the DVD. Just say it, Danny.
I didn't have a Blu-ray player yet.
Get it out, Danny.
So no excuses.
You knew you were going to get one, Danny. You should have just been thinking ahead.
They didn't even do the DVD Blu-ray combos at the time, all right?
Why did they do those?
Because like, so you can upgrade later.
Yeah, like it makes people like, hey, you know, I do have this Blu-ray. Well, maybe I should get the player.
Yeah, it's an extra thing.
But I mean,
just don't know.
I think honestly though, it could hurt the sales because like I know some people like, oh, I bought the DVD, but I got the Blu-ray. Do you want it? I'm like, yeah.
Yeah, I did that when me and Brett split paying for Lion King, and he got the DVD. I got the Blu-ray.
So Danny,
except the case is a little bigger, so now it's in a DVD case with the Blu-ray, so it doesn't fit in. So I'm thinking I should buy the Lion King in the Blu-ray case.
Really?
Oh my God!
Talk about white people.
It's
problem,
a collection man. For me, man. I'm a collector.
That's definitely
it's
white
a collector mentality.
Don't you not own the second season of Mad Men because you don't like the way the case looks?
No, he has.
Because they changed the case. They changed the case.
How do you feel about the case for There Will Be Blood?
Yeah, I don't like that.
He's rebuying.
I don't either.
Mad
yeah,
Man. Yeah, I don't like.
Yeah, I bought the special edition because it was better, but not much.
I got to get the Blu-ray of that. So maybe that's
the
new case.
Better case. I don't know.
I think Blu-ray just has a regular.
Danny. You're going to be on that new sci-fi show.
Oh, the toy collector thing or whatever.
Yeah, Dave's going to be on that.
They have what is it?
It's basically hoarders, but on sci-fi. So it's Danny.
It's people with
like, but
toys
Danny's,
and stuff.
Danny's room's packed. I wouldn't say it's hoarder-ish, though.
Yeah.
No, it is.
It's probably at the beginning steps of it.
The show's not...
Slippery slope.
The show's not like hoarders where like, there's like bugs and it's just like you can't walk. It's Danny's room.
Oh, all right. Yeah, you could be on it then.
Yeah.
My room isn't bad
yet. It's just for people who have too much. Like, they collect too much.
If you put mirrors on your wall, it just look like the room's like ginormous.
Yeah, let's do that. Just make... That's a brilliant idea.
Look at this. It goes back 15 feet over here.
He's just got miles and miles
and
of
then bookcases. And then we'll clean up, but we'll have the cleanup in like really fast motion so I can't really see that part. And then when it comes out, like, it's so clean.
No. Wait, so there's people like go in here and like make them throw out their toys?
Yeah.
No, sell their
or
toys.
Or sell them, yeah, because you make money for them, yeah.
Oh. That's stupid.
No, but my goal is pretty much to...
Have you seen most of the crap they have on sci-fi?
No.
It's awful.
It's the ghost movies. The ghost shows.
No, no.
And it's Shoctopus.
Yeah, it's all those. Those
the fucking there are some shows that Shoctopus I legitimately like.
The awful, awful made for sci-fi it, movies. It's they're a shark.
Yeah, they're all terrible. Together. Yeah. But great to watch.
Oh, my God.
Like, did you see CGI. That
one? Which the one? Shoctopus?
No.
In like clips.
Yeah, they're in like, what is it? They're in like a sub and like, it's like swimming at them.
Oh, that's what we watched part that. Of down at the cave. Yeah, okay.
Oh, my God. It's awesome. It's so fake.
I don't know. I've seen a bunch of them on there.
That's why they're fun.
Pumpkinhead was one of them, wasn't it?
Pumpkinhead? I haven't seen
that. That was an older one that was hilarious. I don't know. It was weird.
Oh, wait. Yeah, that's the one with the kids. Like, they're the teenage kids, and then they do something to the pumpkin, and then he comes alive, and he, like, hacks them up.
Yeah, there's, like, four of them.
What, they do, rape the pumpkin or something? And then he comes back for his
revenge. Was in, like, what was it? He was in, like, a field watching over crops or something, and they, like, desecrated it somehow.
Oh, it's like a scarecrow? So they raped.
Oh, there's like four movies of it or something.
Leprechaun. That's the best. All right.
Starring Jennifer Aniston.
So, what previews did you guys have? Anything good you guys excited
Rise
for?
Rise of the Guardians.
Hobbit. Yeah, Rise of the Guardians, they shown. Yeah. Yeah, Hobbit, I've seen that a bunch. But Rise of the Guardians, the new DreamWorks one.
With Jack Frost.
Yeah. Chris Pine, Captain Kirk.
You guys excited for
Frank and Weenie.
I'm excited for that. It looks good.
Frank and Weenie?
No.
Rise of the Guardians?
Yeah,
me too. Yeah,
jumping ahead. Yeah, I was the first trailer I saw for Rise of the Guardians really focused on Santa Claus. I'm like, why do I want to see this Santa Claus movie where Santa's
doesn't he have like an
crazy
accent in the movie?
Yeah, he's Russian, isn't he?
Yeah, but he's like
the Easter Bunny is Australian for some reason. I don't know about the other two
because he's got a boomerang.
Yeah,
Bunny.
I think that's because he sounds Australian. I don't think it's because he has a boomerang that automatically makes him sound that way.
It's the help to sell the point, Dan.
Yeah, when they were making the movie, they're like, all right, give him a boomerang. Well, we got to get an Australian actor to do this guy. Yeah,
no. Generally, in animated movies, character design comes first, and then you cast the actor. In good animated,
you're
fair,
missing
like
the
Pixar.
Point.
I think it's just to drive it home that it's an Australian.
But I'm pretty sure they started with.
In
the
all honesty,
they started. They put a boomerang on paper and go, okay, what can go with this?
We're gonna draw around the boomerang.
No, you got
this is right. The key factor.
Do you
we
know
needed
this movie is actually
film.
Based around the boomerang? The whole movie is.
It's about Captain Boomerang.
Yes.
Actually.
They just do that, though, so it does well overseas. That's why there's a Russian guy. That's why there's an Australian
Santa
guy.
Claus is originally a German folklore.
Yeah, so that's why he sounds Russian.
So that's why he's Russian, that was, right? That made no sense. That was, thanks, that was bad. Yeah, that
German and Russian sound similar.
No!
No!
Oh, my God.
I'm pretty sure at one point they hated each other. I don't know about now. They probably do. Germans aren't very friendly.
Do you guys
but
know the Germans and the Jews sound so similar? They kind of do.
Well, technically,
depends
they were
on the
a lot
Jew.
Of, you, know?
You know, there's Jews everywhere.
They are best friends.
Well, maybe depends now.
On, yeah, they are now.
60, 70 years ago, not so much.
Yeah. Anyway, I ruined it. I killed the joke.
Yes, you did.
So.
What about the new Tim Burton one?
Frank and Weenie, definitely.
I've been excited for that, yeah.
You I don't
are?
Know. Yeah. I don't know if I'm
what
other,
what
see
else
it.
Did you get for trailers, Kimbo?
Basically.
The Life of Pi, which I thought.
Yeah, yeah.
The CGI on that looked awful.
No, you thought it looked good. It looks good.
I thought it looked good, too. That was in 3D for me, guys.
I disagree, man.
It's going to look good.
Yeah, I don't have much interest
you're
in that.
You're
in
what the did way minority if you think that looks bad. Really? And I mean, like, it's you.
Oh,
no
it looked fine.
Yeah.
I didn't care for it.
I thought it looked like it was done like
was
on
that a
green
book
screen yeah it's a
yeah
book
yeah that's guarantee it that's gonna win the best cinematography Oscar
maybe cinematography but I'm saying from like a special effects
and you can't see
that's true you are blind
yeah but I can tell the difference between practical good
I was,
effects and
I was almost like Danny
CGI
this week
I don't know I don't like I don't really know whether the special effects look good they just looked it looked like a movie to me and then but it doesn't look like a good movie
I don't think I'm gonna look
it looked
yeah,
like
really
it was on green
it,
screen honestly. To me is what it looked like
I was never interested in the book
you know what it is it's Day's dead they create his own 3D so you can actually see through that
I didn't know. There's nothing to do with 3D. It just looked like it was done on soundstage green screen.
I know, but I'm saying
like
your
sky,
eyes.
It looked like Sky Captain or something.
The guy. There's a guy next to me. Is like guy, and I'm assuming it was his daughter. Could have been his niece or whatever. But he like fucking knew. Like, oh, this is Pi. I'm like,
yeah, I knew. It,
I'm like, yeah, me too. I turned to my girlfriend and said the same thing. Oh, Life of Pi.
Oh, you knew what it was?
Yeah.
No, I didn't. But he did it for every preview. I'm like, whoa.
Yeah, I can do that.
Really?
This is Life of Pi.
Most of them, yeah.
Except for Life of Pi. The last time I went to the movies with my dad, they showed a commercial for Les Mis, Yeah. And like it came up.
Which movie was this?
I don't even remember. I'd say it was a while ago.
Because I might have been in that one.
Yeah, you might have.
What
been.
Do you and think
like,
about?
It came up with like working title, like at first, and my dad's like, "That means it's not named." As Anne Hathaway was singing "I Dreamed a Dream," and I'm like, "No, Dad, this is definitely named."
Yeah, working titles a production company.
Yeah, I didn't even go there, but I was like, "No, Dad, this is definitely named."
What do you think of Les Mis, though?
I'm gonna see it. I want to see it. I like the musical.
The whole thing's gonna be a musical?
Yeah.
I don't know.
What do you mean the whole thing? It's no, not the whole thing.
Okay,
musicals.
But it's a musical. If you were to classify the movie, it'd be a musical.
That's what I would. But you wouldn't say the whole thing's a musical.
No, that's what I meant.
Yeah.
They just sing from beginning to end. They never talk.
Jean Valjean is a criminal, and Russell Crowe plays.
There's like a French Revolution too, isn't there?
Yeah, it's set in the backdrop of the French Revolution. Russell Crowe plays the inspector chasing after him. And
I'll definitely see it.
It's a Victor Hugo thing.
Anne Hathaway come in.
Jean Valjean's girlfriend.
I never knew anything about any of the other
ones. Yeah, something like that, yeah.
I'll see it, though. I'll definitely see it.
Is that not Anna Karenina?
Anna Karenina?
Karenina.
Karenina.
I don't know how I feel about that one either.
I'm not interested in that. I don't like Tolstoy, though. So
I like Joe Wright, though.
Yeah, I'm not.
And Aaron Johnson.
I'm out on that. Wait, which one's this?
Anna Karenina?
That's the one where like she's with, they're like Russian royalty almost.
Yeah,
and she ends
I
up
never
cheating
read it,
on him.
Yeah,
what's it called?
That's the one.
Anna Karenina.
Oh, I thought that was like the name of one of the actresses.
No. Phil,
no,
you will see it.
It's Keira Knightley.
Jess wants to see it.
Yeah, exactly. You'll see it.
I'll see it.
Phil sees every movie though.
I like Joe Wright though. Like Atonement was one of my favorite movies of that year.
I didn't. Like
Atonement's
that.
Good, but
I did not like it either.
Yeah.
I never saw Atonement.
You guys all suck.
I liked Atonement.
I didn't even.
That wasn't bad. I just didn't care for it.
I stopped watching.
Oh,
isn't that Natalie Portman?
No,
that's Keira Knightley.
Oh,
and,
sorry.
Saoirse.
What's the difference?
Saoirse Ronan.
There's a lot.
What's
all
the
right?
difference?
Keira Knightley is far better.
No, that's a lie.
Than Portman?
Yeah.
You go watch Clone Wars and tell me that again, okay?
I will.
The Attack of the Clones.
Believe
sorry,
me, I
Clone
will.
Wars. All right. You see the part where Natalie Portman just has beaming nipples and then tell me she's not, okay? It's the only thing I took out of the
just
first
her,
Star Wars.
Her nipples. Her nipples are hard, so that makes her hotter.
Oh, yeah it does.
No, it
fact.
Doesn't.
You can't
dude,
even tell them apart.
Dude, at least Natalie Portman weighs over 100 pounds, okay?
That may be true.
Yes. But Keira Knightley is disgusting because how skinny she is. When she has some weight, she isn't bad.
Who's a better actress, though?
Natalie Portman. Keira
Knightley.
They're both
good.
They're both good.
Keira Knightley's good in... what's that movie?
Pirates of the
Never Let Me Go.
Never Let Me Go.
Yeah, I'm saying people watch that movie.
What's that female's name? Glenn Close is a good actress.
Okay.
How did you jump to
that? Why are you saying Glenn Close? No.
Betty White.
Betty White. Fran Drescher.
Fran Drescher's terrible, and she was in a preview that we saw today.
Yeah,
and it
what
was
that?
Awful.
What?
I don't even remember. I don't even know what movie.
Is it like Francoeini or something?
No, it was the Hotel Transylvania.
Oh, yeah.
I saw that one too. Yeah. What'd you guys think of that?
I kind
of
like it.
I thought it looked like crap.
Oh.
Like, you thought it looked like crap?
I just want... There's a couple funny jokes I laughed at, but on the whole, I thought it just looks like a steaming turd that
I'm down for it.
I got a big...
No. You know what? Danny's completely biased.
Why?
Because Adam Sandler's in it.
I should be biased towards it. I like monster movies and stuff.
Why? You just don't like Adam Sandler?
Yeah, I thought his vampire accent is stupid. And then
it could be the best movie of all time, like written in all the lines, but just listening to Adam Sandler will kill him for that long.
It probably will. Yeah. Cuz I couldn't do that for
wait,
that long.
Wait, you didn't like his
I don't
was
like
the cartoon
the
movie
style
he did.
Either.
I like
Eight Crazy Nights. I think that's really funny, but like the animation style I don't even like really. It's like
in Transylvania.
Yeah.
Hmm. Okay.
I thought it looks good.
So
I won't begrudge people who go and see it, but
Phil, we have the Attic Podcast 7-star scale. What are you giving ParaNorman?
I'll give it a 5.
Okay, Adam?
Sure, that's about what I'd give it.
5. Danny?
I'll give it a 6.
I don't know why we're doing that, but
You gotta review it. You gotta put a number to it.
Yeah,
all the people that listen to it. Phil, are you gonna listen to it and figure out what the numbers are without listening to it right now?
Probably not. No.
There you go.
We always say it though. We always say, "What are you graded on the Attic Podcast 7-star scale?" We're gonna copyright that term.
Go for it.
Really, I'm also gonna give it a 6. I thought it was definitely worth a 6. In terms of an animated movie, I mean, you gotta, you know.
What do you mean in terms of an animated movie? Are you downplaying the animated movies?
I'm just saying that if you'd compare it to a live action, yes.
Depends on which live action.
I'm gonna give it a 5.5.
Ooh.
Ooh. Wow.
Average.
We got a renegade here.
No, he literally just chose the middle of everyone.
He's the renegade of funk.
I like the rad defense.
Oh my god.
All right, so everybody's been playing Darksiders, though, except Phil, though. How's that been going?
Except for Phil. So when did you guys get it? Did you guys all get it Tuesday?
No, I got it Friday.
Yeah, I got it Tuesday.
Tuesday.
Friday.
Hack.
Yep. Did you pre-order it?
No.
Oh, so you didn't get all the sweet bonuses.
No, like, there were still a lot of the...
What's the bonus is that? What's its name?
You get the Argyle's Tomb, yeah. Yeah. Like, everyone got those. Like,
they still have some. I saw them at GameStop yesterday.
That's pretty much just for new copies to get people to buy new ones and not buy the used games.
Well, they already have the stupid thing for
the Crucible.
Crucible
thing. Yeah, I know.
No, I got the Crucible.
I'm thinking about getting the season pass. Would it be worth it?
No idea. I don't know what all the shit is yet.
We don't really know.
Did you guys get the season pass when you bought it? Because they asked you?
No.
I got asked too.
They didn't mention it to me.
Apparently, if you bought it through THQ's website, you could get the season pass for free.
Oh, shit.
Yeah, I didn't look at that. I didn't think of it.
I would have done that.
Yeah,
right? No shit.
But, yeah, you would have got the Argyle's Tomb, too. You would have missed out on, like, the weapons, but that's not a big deal.
Yeah,
the
hell cares?
So, did you guys
pre-order?
How would
you miss out on the weapons?
Some of the stuff from GameStop is weapons.
Yeah, but apparently the Best Buy weapons were the best, I heard someone say.
Yeah, but the GameStop gave you all the extra missions and whatever.
Yeah, I'm more about missions than I am weapons.
Yeah.
I mean,
because
I'm pretty
there's
sure
tons of missions.
It's more content.
Pretty
in
sure
the
it was just fetch quests, but still something to do.
Yeah,
it's content, more content.
Some of them are stupid. I like how, like, in one of the, you know, fetch quests, he's like, I'm not your errand boy, but I'll do it anyway.
Yeah, he kind of changes his tune a lot.
Yeah. I do like the voice actor for this guy, though. Like, he's very wisecracking. Well, he's a different character, because in the first one you play War, and this one you're Death.
I really do like the voice. I like the voice acting throughout. I think it's great.
Yeah. Who's not?
I
is
would,
War
except for
brother?
Half the cutscenes I have just stop with the sound cuts out and the
no, I have to ask. Do we all have it on Xbox 360?
Yes.
Okay,
yes.
So we're all getting the same.
Which
experience.
I hear is the worst.
No, PC is by far worse.
It's
really?
Pretty. It's pretty.
Oh, they're getting fucked.
I'm not gonna. It runs pretty bad on the 360.
Yeah, I've had frame rate drops. I had it lock up.
Like, it's
twice
bad.
On me right
like
now
the frame. I got. I jumped off an edge and I got stuck in like.
GM. That happened to me once.
You know what? Knock on wood. God damn it! But I haven't.
Your
had,
chair, dumbass.
I have not had any problems with it. No. I mean, every once in a while.
You're on like the third mission. Yeah.
I don't know. I haven't had any problems. I've been playing for a while.
Well, those first two missions didn't fuck me up, so.
What's a while? Like, how many hours?
I'm in the middle of doing the tiers.
Yeah, but how many hours?
You're on like the third mission.
That's not. This is
I don't know how many hours. Whatever. I put enough time in, though.
No, it didn't start fucking up for me until I started getting to the land of the dead, and then it just started skipping cutscenes, and I ended up with a power I don't understand how I got.
What do you guys like the story?
Yeah.
Yes.
God, I don't like it.
You don't care.
You just can't follow it.
You're on the second mission.
Yeah, but the basic story is there. The story is you're trying to resurrect humanity after they destroyed the apocalypse.
A lot of it goes into what corruption is, which he has.
Why aren't I playing this
I
game?
I haven't got to corruption.
You play as
either
death.
At all.
It's pretty
this
awesome.
This sounds awesome.
Yeah.
You go around awesome. And killing shit.
The gameplay itself is fantastic.
Yeah, especially when you're like, you know, you'll like slice at these guys, jump away, slice at these guys.
Do you guys like.
How long did it take you guys to beat Thane? I can't fuck beat that guy.
I did it after like the second or third mission.
I've died by one enemy.
Really? I've died a few times.
Dude, there's one guy.
The only thing I die for is.
Yeah, I'm on the hardest difficulty, so I get pretty raped every once
in
a while.
Can,
I'm playing normal.
I'm normal, too. Yep. What are you playing?
Normal.
Easy. And
shut up. I'm better than both you and Danny at games.
Hey, I at least beat the first game. Charlie over here couldn't get past the first boss.
That
was not the first boss, you jerk.
That was the first boss.
No, it wasn't.
It was the first boss. In the first game, he couldn't get past the bat guy you fight. That's the first boss, right?
What?
In the first game, the huge bat thing that flies around.
That's the, technically, I mean, you fight Straga at the beginning, but
yeah, that doesn't count.
That's like the
opening.
Yeah, that's during the apocalypse.
Danny has a lot of deaths because when I looked at your thing, it says 91.
Oh yeah, dude, I'm just jumping off.
Yeah, the problem is the platforming
is the worst part. Like when you're trying to like run straight up, and sometimes it'll go end up running to the side.
Yeah, that is when I have some problems.
The problems I have is like when you get to turn and jump to like another column.
Oh yeah,
when you get to hold L1.
Yeah,
that's when
like
I have
direct it which way to
L1. You play in the PS2?
Yeah.
Well, left trigger.
Yeah, L1. Sorry.
Trigger bumper. L1 out there. Who cares?
Whatever. You knew what I meant.
Yeah.
Somebody
yeah.
fired.
Yeah, that's the worst
themselves.
Part. I don't
Pretty
know.
Sure it was you.
Probably you.
I was like, poop.
No,
wow,
but
shock.
It could be my sock is off. My shoe is off.
Oh, my God.
Would you just take it off?
No, it's been off like the
you
whole time.
You know how
time,
we're playing is death? It smells like that.
So would... Go ahead.
Yeah, but on the platforming though, that is the worst part about it because I don't remember doing that as much with the first one.
No, definitely not.
But I feel like in this one they've wanted it to be faster. Like there's one part I think you probably played this that my brother's playing where you have to like run up the inside of like a tower and there's like lava chasing
you.
There's
like three of those sections, one of which was worse than the other two by far.
Yeah, so like they're trying to make it a lot more quicker with the platforming.
And it pissed me off because the last time I did it, I was ahead of it so far, and then it just like just the lava level decided, oh fuck, I better catch up, and just shot right the fuck up towards me.
Yeah.
It's a good game though. Music's awesome.
Yeah,
I do like the music too, cool. Yeah.
Yeah, the music behind it's great. And the story is great. I really like the story.
I wish he would stop yelling at me every time I accidentally hit both the shoulder buttons. And it's like, you can't ride the horse here.
Oh, yeah.
I fucking know
this
that.
Place isn't, I do it on purpose just to listen to him.
Yeah.
This place is not fit for a horse.
I
have to go alone.
I also like when you get to the angels, they're just like, oh, the horseman cometh. I'm like, get it. It's like the book. Iceman cometh. Please, God, tell me you know what I'm talking about.
Nope.
I do know
you're an idiot.
The title, but I never read it.
Oh, I never read it either. I just know.
Is there a lot of connection?
What is this?
Iceman Cometh, you know the book.
Oh yeah, I saw the movie too.
Oh well, I didn't read or watch it, but
it's a play, isn't it?
Sure, why not? Yeah. Yes, it is actually. Yeah. But in one of the parts, the enemies are just like, "Oh, the horseman cometh." I'm like, ah, I get it.
Is there a lot of connection though between this one and the first one?
No,
not really. That's the best part about this game. They do a good job of just like, all right. Your brother got imprisoned, and now we're going to tell you what was happening when that was happening.
Yeah, so it does really a very good job of letting like new players play. You know what I mean? Like somebody like Kimball. Even though I didn't beat the first one, but like I could still
You meet up with a few of the characters from the first one.
And they mention one of the
my favorite's the dude. Thing. My favorite's the dude you trade with.
Volgrim?
Yes.
He doesn't do much in this.
Is that... That's not... Mark Hamill was Volgrim in the first one,
No, Mark
right?
Hamill is the... little spirit thing in your hand.
Oh, all right. Yeah, that's what it was. Because I was confusing those
guys. I like that old dude you fight in the beginning. And he turns into your brother.
Oh, Crowfather?
Yeah, the Crowfather.
Yeah, he comes back.
I like that dude.
Oh, yeah.
So how long is the game, though? Like, how many?
22 20-ish. Hours is what I've been hearing, yeah.
Oh, really? It's not that long.
Yeah.
No, it's pretty decent for this
kind
of game,
Is that with doing all the quests, or is that just...
That's just probably...
It's probably doing some of it, but not all. Because if you can do it that quickly and finding all those stupid-as-fuck collectibles, then all the power to you. But there is very little chance of you doing it that quickly.
Collecting the... Yeah, you guys trying to do that? Or?
Yeah. Oh,
I know Adam is... collect the pages for Volgrim.
You have to collect the pages, 3 sets of stones.
Yeah, there's 25 stones in each one, isn't there?
I don't know.
I think it's 25.
There's
a
bunch of relics you're
the
supposed
stones
to get.
For that guy?
Yeah.
That's like he needs to eat? Yeah.
When you get to the land of the dead, you have to start looking for relics of something. I don't know. I didn't pay that much attention to it.
And it probably cut out when you're doing
it. No, this one didn't. It wasn't until later on in that it started doing that.
Yeah.
Like when I got to the throne of the land of the dead or whatever. But I'm pretty sure there's one other thing you're supposed to start. Oh, when you're doing something on Earth, you're supposed to find like 10 angels to kill or something. I found 9 of them somehow, and I was just pissed because I didn't want to go look for one.
So you're not going to go back?
Oh, I will. I just, at the time, I was like,
all
right, screw
it.
And
all the chests, too, but those are at least on the map.
So you went right to hard?
Yeah.
Wow, that's rough.
Yeah,
there were a few points that I kind of got just so screwed.
Yeah, there's one like sort of side boss off to the side. I've been fighting Gorgoroth. Like you've got to like find him. You've got to like swim down through water and then like pop.
I like
through.
That how they have those.
What, the swimming?
Yeah. Well, yeah. And like I jumped in some, like, it looked, just looked like a little puddle, and I jumped in. I'm like, wow, it's a big road.
Which one was that?
It's like, but on your way to the first place you're going to, you've got to go past where Volgrim is.
Yeah.
He's got a shop there, and there's like this water there, and then there's like ruins that you have to get a key to open. And then you go into this room, and then if you go in the back way, you can like swim down to this area. You might not have found it yet. I don't know.
But you gotta, like, I have to see what it looks like.
Yeah. But yeah, I keep losing this guy. Nick beat him, but Nick was just watching me do it. He's like, you suck. And then he went and did it when I wasn't home. So I don't know how he did it, but apparently
really?
He did it. Yeah.
Are you guys both playing the same save? Or?
No, we're playing different ones. He's ahead of me now. I was ahead of him for a while, but he caught up.
How do you play different saves?
You're going to have this four saves.
Yeah,
this
four save slots. Playing different games.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, it's a save slot. So you just hit save and it saves. That's right, okay.
But I was saying to Nick, though, like, doing the, like, puzzle things, it's basically just moving stuff around. I was saying, you feel kind of stupid when you don't figure it out, because they're usually pretty simple.
I know.
And once you figure it out, I was like, oh, all I had to do was flip this one switch. I feel like
it gets harder when you have to split yourself into two.
You have to split your character into two, and like
you one of the power that I got after not knowing what the cutscene told me.
Yeah,
your body turns to stone, and you have your soul split in two that you can control.
So he can like stand on switches and shit.
That's what you're supposed to do with it.
Yeah.
Some of it you have to. A lot of the times it's like you have to hit a switch so that you can go to a new area, but you have to stay on the switch.
Yeah,
but your body has to be the one to stay in there. So usually there's like a block you can move. You pull it out and then go back to your body, jump on top of it, and leave that on the block, and then move it in.
Yeah.
So it's kind of just like you have to figure out when that's supposed to happen.
Yeah. Wow, that's kind of fucked up.
I like the puzzles, though. I actually do really enjoy them. They're a little tough because of the control issues, as you and Kimball were talking about. But
especially
I mean,
when they're time sensitive or something. Where
I've only ran across one.
The same one that I ran across where that thing was falling into the lava.
Yeah. Oh, you see, you're not that far behind.
And you had to go around it yet. No, I'm really not.
And
is it close?
Yeah.
But yeah, that was kind of a bitch. I want to play it really bad.
I think it was a bitch. I did it twice. I was like,
I kept falling off so many times.
Oh, really?
But not because I was like, I did it the wrong way. And not even because, like, I couldn't get to that thing in time. I just kept jumping at it the wrong way, and I kept missing it.
I just hate, like, I did it twice now. Like, I've both dungeons I went to, I, like, totally did, like, everything that, like, was more or less, you know, possible, except for, like, the last thing. And I'm like, I just don't know what to do now. I just don't know. What do I do? I went back, checked, nothing happened new here, went back. I don't know. I'm looking it up. Fuck it. And then, like, retarded, because, like, in the first dungeon, like, I didn't, like, I don't know. I just didn't, like, you know how the wall looks a little different when you're supposed to run sideways?
Yeah.
I just didn't catch it, and I didn't run sideways over to the vines. And then...
that becomes a problem sometimes.
And then in the second dungeon, you haven't been there. That whole switch thing, I didn't even know that was fucking up there. I didn't even jump on... It didn't even occur to me, like, I should probably jump on this.
That one, I can't believe you didn't get.
I didn't even.
There, cause
if I knew
like,
that.
It's in the center of the room almost.
If
the,
I knew
like,
that it was there, I probably would have figured it. I know I would have figured it out. But
yeah.
The fact, I just never jumped
the
up on
it. The
fact
that it was a little raised.
Yeah, I was like, I just didn't, like, I didn't even, I don't know why I didn't try it, but I was like, I gotta look this up.
What the hell boss are you talking about?
It's off to the side. I gotta show it to you.
What's
it's
name?
It's not like a boss. It's like something Roth at the end of it. I think it's Gorgoroth or Ogoroth. It's not necessarily a boss. It's just like a guy you find that's guarding a chest. And he sends like roots out at you.
I have no idea.
Yeah. I'll show it to you.
He's going to show you.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
But I am liking it. Because like, there's not enough games that are like Zelda. Like Ocarina of Time and stuff.
This
like,
is very Zelda-ish.
Yeah. Like the last game that is similar to this is actually good is like 2008 Prince of Persia.
I never played Zelda.
I haven't either.
This reminds me, it has like elements.
That's why I don't like Zelda is because the combat sucks in Zelda games now. And this is actually an interesting combat system.
I think the combat is fantastic.
Yeah, I think it is too.
So are you guys slow secondary weapon or fast?
Slow.
Dude, just using the hammer, man. You got to bring the hammer at the end.
Fast.
Out of the misery.
I just switched the fast. I think I like the fast.
Your secondary weapon's fast too?
Yeah.
Wow.
Well, my secondary weapon is faster than my primary.
Yeah, mine is too, and it gives me health, like a ridiculous amount.
I could really use the health. How did you get the health?
One of the bosses.
I need. Yeah,
have you guys used the possess weapons at all?
Yeah.
I have one. I was using that.
Yeah.
That's actually what my fast one is. It's possessed.
Yeah.
It's pretty good. I like it.
Yeah, because then you can like feed like other weapons to it, and then you can get
it's
those,
worth a
like,
shit ton if you're going to sell it, though.
Yeah.
Yeah, but that actually that makes less of a difference after a while.
Why? Gold doesn't become a problem later on?
Yeah, everything's worth a lot. I have like 800 grand right now. No. I have not bought a damn thing.
No.
Yeah, me either. I don't like.
I bought upgrades. That's what I bought. Like different
what are
moves.
The What do the upgrades do?
You can like, buy like upgrade moves,
just
right?
Just like no, it's like different attack pattern.
Right. Yeah. From yeah, like Thane and stuff.
It, yeah. But if you, yeah, but like if you know,
I just button mash anyways.
So yeah. On hit, like if you hit like X, like if you buy the upgrade, you can hit X 3 times, and it does like a special move. So yeah. Like that doesn't actually naturally progressively happen, or
it does.
All I know is so. I use teleport teleport slash like a motherfucker because it's very helpful in when it's harder.
It's hard to get that to hit sometimes.
Yeah,
though.
But it's better than me trying to run up and then getting destroyed when he can hit me for half my health.
Yeah.
I just Does teleport slash in on, and then
That's
back
true.
Up.
That's you.
I have a question. If
true.
I'm on like a cliff, right, and there's a boss, or not even a boss, just an enemy on the other side, can I teleport slash it to get across like a...
I don't think so.
I don't know. I've
It depends
never
on
seen
the cliff.
That happen.
It depends on where you're on the cliff, I would think.
Okay. I don't,
on the way down to that castle where, like, for the tier mission.
Sure.
There's, like, that water off to the side.
Sure. Oh, to the right after the dude who wants all the stones?
Yes.
Yeah, you can... Yeah, I don't know how to get over there yet.
You don't know how to get... You know what I'm talking? There's, yeah, like, that bridge you can get on and then right across it, there's
a
chest.
Yeah, there's a treasure chest there, and it's annoying the shit out of me that I can't get to it.
I had like the tiniest...
Also, if you want to know, if you continue going through the water, there's a Volgrim spot.
What's a Volgrim?
Oh, thank you.
What's a Volgrim spot?
The shopkeeper.
And
Volgrim,
if you go to the other part that's there, you can find. Have you found the giant construct thing yet?
I got my
maybe,
ass.
Maybe not. I know I have
not
the
guardian, the warden before it.
No, I don't think so.
He'll give you a mission to find another one, and he's over there. Then you have to go find his body parts, which are just in random spots.
I got my ass kicked going through that lane. So the lands right there up to the water the first time.
Those by those things?
Yeah.
I didn't.
Oh, yeah. There's one that like catches on fire and just starts.
When he hits
you,
like it knocked half my thing away.
When you get to the land of the dead, I would stay away from the tomb of the deposed king or whatever it is, because he will just destroy you if you're not leveled up.
Do you grind at all?
I don't. You can't really.
Because
not all the guys there aren't really high enough level.
Yeah,
for, like,
all the ones
one
that that respawn don't give you that much.
No, why did I get owned so bad by him?
You just not. Maybe it might be the weapons you're using.
Maybe because I just switch my weapons.
Yeah,
my weapon gives me money every time I hit them.
Really? That's why you have so much fucking money.
No, actually, it's because I sold a bunch of shit. It doesn't get
you know
what I
like, though? There is kind of a parody in the money. Like, I went to somebody, and I wanted to buy, like, health, and I checked the health. 1,000, like, coins, but then I can only sell mine for 200. That's, like, ridiculous.
That's not a parody.
Yeah, parody.
A parody is something that's made to make fun of something else.
No, I know, but they use it. They use
they're
it.
They're making fun of him, right?
They use it in terms of like football. They say there's a lot of parody in football because like the team that like goes undefeated one year, the next year will go like 0-16. So it's the same thing as like $1,000 and $200.
Yeah, those ones are spelled differently, but I think you're pronouncing it a little wrong.
No, it's parody.
No, it's like parody. It's parody.
You said the same.
Jesus Christ!
He said the same thing.
Stop. Anyway, I don't like that. Like, I understand that. Like, I'm not going to be able to sell it for $1,000.
Why are you going to sell it anyways?
That's the way. I'm just saying.
I've had to buy so many of those things because I go through those potions.
Yeah, really I understand.
Quickly.
I understand now, how. Like,
does it automatically use it if you're about to die?
It does
no.
not.
It doesn't. That's the worst part because you got to hit side on the D-pad and it's just like I'm not getting down there quick enough. Oh, I'm dead.
They had What was I going to say?
Health?
I forget. I don't
talking
know.
About health?
You know what I don't like about that, too, is if you hit it, right, it'll start regenerating. But if you get hit while it's regenerating, it'll stop right where you get right where
no,
it
won't.
Is.
No, it won't.
Yeah, it will.
No, it won't.
Okay.
I haven't seen that happen.
Either that or I just have no defense and it goes down.
I would not be as far as I am if that was the case.
Yeah, that doesn't happen.
I would have been just destroyed.
That's what's happening to me every time
I use... It might seem like that because it'll take your health down. It just seems like it's not moving.
Damn. Oh, it is.
Then either that or I have no...
You'll probably find a tough guy.
No defense and it just goes down a shit ton.
Probably.
Maybe.
I don't know. To me, it seems like it
stops. What's your defense at? What's your number?
I don't fucking know.
Neither do I.
So what are you guys using? Like when you get skill points, which one are you going for?
The things that have to do with the ghouls, like you can
right
like
side.
Yeah, the right side. I always go for the ghouls too.
Yeah, you can resurrect them.
Yeah, me and Adam are left.
Oh. Really?
Yeah.
See, that, dude, the final.
You guys are also playing fast too. Like
the
we're
final
playing
attack
with
that you get for that is fucking awesome. You like make a giant tornado around you and can just destroy things.
You can just throw like what are those glades?
Yeah, but the way I look at it is it'll be
yeah,
more...
Yeah, I use that attack too.
This would be more helpful for me because eventually you can raise up the defense of the ghouls and then eventually you can have it so the enemies focus on the ghouls.
Yeah, and then you can just be like shooting with your gun.
Or whatever, just to attack from behind with like the hammer.
Yeah.
You know,
well, see,
like
what
that.
I do is the teleport slash is the first thing that you get on that side. And what I do is I attack with it and then back right the fuck up so I don't get hit. And then if you just use your guns, you can bring up your wrath all the way up again. Unless they block it but a lot. But that
yeah, and then use
happens.
One of those attacks.
What, because the teleport uses your wrath?
Yeah, yeah. Yeah. All those like special attacks, I guess.
You can use it like three times and then you need to replenish. But I usually just shoot them in between. Oh. And it replenishes most.
See, the
it.
Only time I really use teleport slash is when I'm first coming approaching an enemy.
Yeah, that's me too.
I use it when I'm fighting something that if I try to stay near it and attack it, it will just destroy me.
Yeah. You're like playing a different game because you're on hard.
I got confused though. I was playing Dust and I couldn't remember. I thought there was a block move in this because in Dust, like it's a side scroller.
There's
an attack,
there
and you can
move.
And you can like
I wish
block
there was too.
And it parries them, and then they're dizzy, and then you can take them down. But like, in this game, it's just like no, you did.
How do you get it? How do you actually get it so you can use the B button to finish them?
There's a 10% chance unless your weapons increase that.
Oh, okay.
I don't get it that often.
I get it quite a bit, but it's not really a big...
Yeah, it's like, it's not as helpful as you'd hope.
Well, when you use that, sometimes it'll give you stuff back. That's why
it's
good to
use
those. Yeah,
but I usually don't need it.
Yeah.
What does it give you, like health or...
Yeah, health or... Wrath points, too.
How far down do I have to go before I get health from using teleport slash?
It's only a few of them down.
All right, because that's...
Then it starts going to, like, harvest
Getting skill points is such a pain.
They take a long time.
Ugh.
I got fucking totally saved. Apparently, when you go up a level, it regens your whole health. Mm-hmm. I was in the middle of a fight, nearly dead, fucking upgrade. I was like, yes.
I mean, what's nice is I...
What do you lose for dying?
Nothing.
So it's not a big deal?
No, really dying isn't that big of a deal. Just
And it's kind of hard to die because you can like pause the game, fast travel.
Well,
yeah, but you don't die in the worst part. Like it's easy to like pause the game, fast travel, buy some health potions, and then fast travel back.
No, it's pretty easy to die.
It's still easy to die too, yes.
The only thing, you know what it does? Like if you're doing if you're fighting a boss, not that big of a deal. Go back and fight the boss. It can be a pain sometimes. You're doing like a tougher, longer puzzle because it brings you back. Like if you fall in, right?
It usually just brings me right back.
It brings you right back. But
the auto saves are actually pretty decent.
What happens is you have health, right? And when you fall in, it takes a little bit of health, but puts you right back where you were.
Yeah.
Right. If you lose all that health from falling in somewhere.
Yeah.
It brings you back to the beginning of the puzzle again.
Wow.
Oh, you're a damn fall for losing all your health. The only thing
you fall in a lot? Because like, I didn't even know that.
Yeah.
The only time you don't lose health for falling unless there's lava.
I freaking...
It's when you fall and die. And they have to bring
don't
you...
Don't do it.
Well, no, I don't do it that often. It was just I had no health.
That's
I had just
a lot
like fought...
Death.
I just fought in somebody. Fought somebody.
Fought-in?
Yeah, I just fought somebody. Fought-in. And I went into the next place. I had to do a puzzle. And I fell and died.
Do you know how I just got the lava flowing and then you go back to that cat in the castle in the middle there, what's the name of it?
And you talk to that girl,
Ayla. And so I was just jumping over the walls and I fucking jumped right into the lava. I was like, fuck. So
I just did all this.
I know. So but whatever. So but you guys all like it though.
Yeah. Hopefully it sells well.
I'm a little upset. Probably would have rather had I don't know, I'm not gonna lie. I'm enjoying it more now than it did when I the first 2 hours.
Yeah, it starts a little slow. Like the Crowfather stuff is a little.
I'm enjoying it more now, but I don't know. I kind of want to get Sleeping Dogs.
Yeah, I've heard good things about that. Yeah.
I know, right? Wow, they did a very good job.
I've heard a lot of good things about it.
Coming back from what it was,
yeah.
Supposedly.
Yeah, I need to finish Kingdom Hearts.
Yes, you do.
I need to, I want to play Dust now. I've been playing Dust, so that's pretty cool.
Is Dust very long? I downloaded that
If you
today.
Override my save, I will murder you.
I won't override your save. Is there multiple saves?
Two, I think.
Okay, that's fine.
You might do it.
No, but Dust.
I'll probably just play yours, just actually understand what I'm doing.
It's very weird because it kind of gives you like the beginning and it's like, all right, we're just going to skip ahead a while. Now you're in the first world. And then it just shows you like flashbacks and it's weird and annoying.
Yeah. I'm enjoying Darksiders though. I really am. Danny has the weirdest look on his face right now. It's creeping me out a little bit.
No, I hit the mic.
He hit the mic and he's acting like the world just fucking ended or he sharded himself or something.
It was loud.
I didn't know you hit it. I just didn't know what happened.
Oh, all right. Then go.
Alrighty. So.
Bring us to the end of the show.
Yeah, probably.
Check out Dust, though, if you like what is it? Shadow Ops, Metroidvania stuff. It's got
great buy it
anime.
Just because one guy made the game.
Yeah, pretty much. They have a huge voice cast on the game, though, which is
nuts. Buy it for that guy. He's a good guy, too. Like, I shook his hand and talked to him for a little bit.
This guy who made Dust.
Yeah, right. And it's just like one man who just went through and made like the whole game basically by himself.
So check it out.
Does it suck?
No, it's awesome.
It's good.
Do you like Castlevania? Okay.
Maybe. I don't know.
It's the wrong person.
Video games and Phil go together like Mitt Romney and Obama.
Resident Evil's.
Don't start this again. I will fucking murder you.
They're the same person.
They
Stop
pretty much
this.
Are.
They both suck equally.
Yeah. Alrighty then. We'll see you next week, kidlets.
All right. You can check us out on YouTube.com. YouTube.com/addictpodcast.
Yeah, there you go. Yeah.
Review us on iTunes, kids. Yep. Please do
and,
that.
And please follow us on Twitter at @addictpodcast.
Like us on Facebook, do it. Facebook.com.
I downloaded
you're talking to three people.
I downloaded the Twitter app from my iPad.
Tell your friends and family. Just tell everyone. Even if it's your worst enemy, just tell them to listen to the Addict Podcast.
Especially if it's your worst enemy.
Yeah, it's probably a good torture.
We might
get
some high class listeners because we went to a few uppity coffee joints. I've been leaving cards out.
Yeah, I'm sure that'll work out.
That's a good idea.
Yeah, I went to
the hipster crowd.
The hipster crowd.
I got a whole stack of Natick, Dover, Wellesley.
What, you just leaving them at like coffee shops? Yeah, can you get
no? There's like an empty card hold, and I just take advantage of it. Yeah.
You know what sucks is like really arcades don't exist anymore. We just go around to arcades everywhere and just drop them in arcades.
Hey kid, you like podcasts?
You can just do it like you guys did.
I got a podcast in the car for you.
At least leave you shaved. It wouldn't be that creepy.
Hey, I got us. I don't know if they really listen, but I've somebody actually found one in Sovereign Bank near my house, and was like, and actually took it and like put it in their wallet.
Just because they saw him put it in the... I just
it's because they went to KP and they know us.
Yeah, not us. Because you
PJ
didn't
Matz,
go there.
Paul Matz.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, that doesn't count.
I know, but still.
Hey, kid, you like a podcast?
Still, there's somebody.
I got to start placing morale places.
You still
places.
Get... But what's a podcast? I'm like, forget it. It's not for you.
You know what else you should do? Is you should put it in every check.
I wish I stopped at my house to
what
get my
check.
Shit.
Like when you go out to dinner, put one in the check.
Oh, in the check.
Yeah, like when they bring in the check.
I gave it to one of the state registry cops who inspect our buses. He's like, he's like, we're talking about video games. I'm like, here, you want to listen to our show?
Dude, drop them on the buses.
Okay.
No, because
then
I could get in trouble by that. All right.
We'll see you next week.
All right, bye.